In this video, we discuss the basics of classification and its terminology. First, let's start with an example of a self-checkout machine in a supermarket and how this application could be powered by machine learning. The self-checkout works as follows. First, you do your shopping, and when you are done, you go to the machine and you scan the barcode of your product. Afterward, you put your product in your basket. Now the product is measured using all kinds of sensors. For example, the color could be measured by a camera, and the weight can be determined by a scale under the basket. These measurements are our feature vectors for the object. Now, a model uses these features as input and will try to predict which product it is, called the class. Is it an apple or is it a banana, etc. If the predicted class agrees with the scanned barcode, nothing happens. However, if the predicted class does not agree with the scanned barcode, the self-checkout machine suspects that you secretly switched items. In this case, it could, for example, send an employee to check your products. How do we make such a classification model? First, you need examples. You need some apples, you need some bananas, etc., etc., and you measure their features. You take your sensor, for example, you weigh your products, you measure their color, etc. You make this data set of examples with features and their labels. This will be our training data. This training data is input to our learning algorithm, which tries to come up with a classification model. This model is usually governed internally by some kind of parameters. This classification model can take a new object as input, its features as input, and will try to predict its class. For classification using two features, a so-called two-dimensional classification problem, we can easily plot our model and our data. Our classification model divides the space into different regions for each class, and these regions are separated by what is called the decision boundary. That is the boundary where the model changes its decision. Our previous example was a so-called binary classification problem, meaning we have two classes, apple and banana. In a multi-class classification problem, we can have many more classes. For example, here we have six classes: apple, banana, mango, broccoli, tomato, and eggplant. Finally, after training our model, we usually want to evaluate its performance on new and unseen data. For classification, performance is often measured using the accuracy. The accuracy is the number of correctly predicted samples divided by the total number of objects. This is the percentage of objects that are correctly classified. We can also evaluate using the error rate. The error rate measures the opposite of accuracy. We count the number of mistakes and divide by the total to get to the error rate. This is the percentage of objects that are misclassified. Now, here is a question for you to check your understanding of this concept. What is the error rate for the classifier here on the right? Please pause the video and take a moment to compute it, and then we discuss the answer afterward. Okay, welcome back. Here on the right, we see that two objects are misclassified. That is, one banana is misclassified and one apple is misclassified. There are a total of 12 objects. Thus, the error rate is 2 divided by 12, which is approximately 17%.